What up, peeps? Mr. Bone back at you, and I've got a Blu-ray update here to share with you. Let's get up in that. First, I'll show you what I got from the Dollar Tree for this wave. I was lucky enough to get something from this wave. I checked my local Dollar Tree, which is up the road from me, which is where I usually find good shit, and they had nothing but oceans of DVDs, maybe 5 Blu-ray, nothing good. So I didn't buy shit and went home. And then the next day, which was today, me and my wife was in town doing shit, and I stopped at the one that usually has nothing. And they still, their table was pretty bare, but they had 3 titles that I've seen people get in the past that I wanted to get. And probably the best one is complete season 1 of Jim and the Holograms. Granted, I guess it generally is a girl's cartoon, but I remember watching this as a kid back in the days, in the 80s. Complete season from Shout Factory. Pretty sweet for a buck. I'd buy that for $1. I've seen people pick this up lately. Found me a copy called The Project. There's No Escape. I wasn't sure if this looked anything like a horror genre movie, or then I read the back and it has a long ass description, and then not till the end does it say something about this chick is kidnapped in this place, and not till the end of it does it say Melody starts seeing a double of herself who starts giving her instructions on how to escape. And you got that like creepy hand of face coming out that door there. Yeah, I got 3 things from this wave. I found this horror triple feature people have been getting. It says volume 2. I wonder what was on volume 1. It's got Scar, unrated director's cut, which I think is supposed to be Scar 3D, but I guess that's what it is. Terror Trap and Midnight Movie. I've only seen Terror Trap, which has Michael Madsen, Jeff Fahey, and David James Elliott. I've only seen it, and it, if I remember right, it reminded me of Vacancy. It was decent. Vacancy is a real good movie, so if you like that, then you might want to check out Terror Trap. That's my 3 pickups from, next up, I'll show what I got at the flea market this past weekend. The guy I usually trade with was took a dose of dumb pills or something. He's acting stupid. I gave him a big stack of movies on his table, stuff I didn't want, but you gotta give me something for my shit, you know? Extras, and there were DVDs. And I have 4, I picked 4 of his Blu-rays, and he tried to say he would take my trade plus one at $8, and I looked at him like he was stupid. So then he said the most he could give me was 2, so I chose Outsiders and A Quiet Place. And then, I pulled out a Blu-ray, a shitty Blu-ray from the Dollar Tree called Nature Calls or something, gave him that for The Dark Knight Rises. It was the last one I needed of the Nolan trilogy. I had 4 of his, but then I realized he gives a fuck anyway. One of them was a dented up steelbook, but I didn't realize it was so dented up until I got it up to his desk in the light, which is Hercules, The Rock's Hercules. So I got pretty much what I wanted out of him in the end anyway. Stack of shitty DVDs that I didn't care for 2 of them, and I just gave him a shitty Blu-ray for the other one. then I got my happy ass out of his booth because he was getting on my nerves. And I went to the next booth over, found this chick selling newer releases for a buck. And I found 47 Meters Down for a dollar. Fuck yeah. I had already had the sequel, which is 47 Meters Down a Cage. Got it for like $7 or something at Walmart, but I never see this one up there. Now I have them both. Next, I found these at the local pawn shop. $2 a piece. Rampage, which I've been needing. But this slipcover looks like hell, so I don't know. I'm going to decide if it's fake or I'll just toss them. Got that ugly damage on the sticker and it's all done up, so I don't know. Rampage is a good movie. This one here is one of my favorite movies. Favorite newer movies called The Covenant. I don't know if anybody else likes this. I never hear anybody talk about it, but I consider this, I call this the boy version of The Craft. They're warlocks or wizards. There's a funny scene at the beginning where they're running from cops and they just make their car disappear. It's like hanging below the cliff or floating above it or something. And they say, Harry Potter can kiss my ass. And it's a pretty cool movie. It had a pretty cool story. I believe they're called the Sons of Ipwich. And the group of them are friends. They all hang out. But there's another one that they don't know about that comes into town and he's evil. And he's been going around killing the other Sons of Ipwich or the other wizards or whatever and taking their power. And the main kid, the main good one, has to fight him, and toward the end, his father, who's old, wields his powers over to him to make him stronger, is able to compete with the other bad guy. It's the fight going on at the bottom. The other bad guy has all kinds of power from people he's been taking it from. It's a good movie. Found Wonder Woman on 4K for $2. Watch out. I've only seen this once, but I like the superhero movies. I guess it's better than the sequel. I haven't seen it either, but everybody shits all over it. I found my favorite Nick Cage at the pawn shop for $2. Never see this in pawn shops or anywhere. Put the bunny back in the box. Connor, why didn't you just put the bunny back in the box? And we have, about a month ago, I got this at Walmart for like $14. All three Beverly Hills Cops. This is nothing special, they don't have no order. And last but not least, I got this in the mail today. Wonder what it is. I know what it is. Is the newest release from Vestron. Sundown, the Vampire in Retreat. See, my Walmart, and that's all we have in this little shitty town for new releases of physical media, my Walmart fucking sucks. The last release, The Wraith, I pre-ordered it. And then I went to Walmart for something, and there was the Wraith all shiny in my face. So I'm like, well, if they're going to carry these, I'll just get the next one from here. Tuesday rolls around, I go there, nothing. But I've been watching other people's videos of them picking it up at Walmart on Tuesday. And I go up, and I ask the lady about it, if they have it in the back or whatever. She looks it up on her phone, and on the website it says it's for pre-order. I'm like, no, it's out. It came out today. I've been watching people pick it up on YouTube. No, they probably was pre-ordering it and then going to the store and picking it up. Thought to myself, no, dummy, but said, okay, and I left. And I went home and I ordered it. So, yeah. There was a nice convenience to be able to go to Walmart and just grab these at only like $12.96, but I didn't miss. I did get Little Monsters and Shivers from there. Then they decided to carry the Wraith, but they didn't get this one. Comes with a digital code, disc art, and a lovely fucking eco case. Always have to try to find extra cases to switch those out. Yeah, here's the inside of Jim and the Holograms. Four discs. And they kind of look like records. I don't know if the camera picks that up with the lines in it and stuff. Looks like vinyls. Pretty cool. Pick up. Hope you enjoyed watching, checking out my video. Peace.